We have discussed the design of a grid-connected PV system. In this video, you will learn about self-consumption, which is a concept that is predominantly associated with the grid-connected PV systems. We will start by defining the concept of self-consumption, then we will look at the importance and the advantages of self-consumption itself. Due to the fluctuations in PV power generation, along with the increased penetration of PV systems into the grid, the effective management of the grid by the utility companies has become difficult. If the grid injection level of PV systems exceeds the current demand of a grid, the stability of the grid can potentially be threatened. One solution to avoid these grid stability issues is to allow the producer to consume the generated PV power directly, rather than injecting the power into the grid. In this way, the PV producers are at the same time consumers, thereby becoming the so-called prosumers. This phenomenon is known as self-consumption. Self-consumption is defined as the possibility for the electricity consumer to produce PV power on their own, so that they can fulfill their load demand entirely without utilizing the electricity grid. The major challenge for self-consumption is the disparity between the PV power generation and the actual load demand. This figure shows how an average household with a PV system interacts with the grid. The red region indicates the total load consumption of the household, and the green region indicates the total PV production during the day. We can clearly see that the imbalance between the production and consumption. Solar electricity is only available during the day, while the largest fraction of the load demand occurs during non-PV production hours. The small region in the middle, where the two areas overlap, corresponds to the self-consumption region. In this region, the load demand is fully met by the PV production. The excess PV generation during this period is fed into the grid, so that it can be retrieved at a later time. So, what are the reasons to allow self-consumption in your PV system? The primary benefit, as mentioned earlier, is to reduce stress on the electricity grid. By allowing self-consumption, the amount of electricity instantaneously injected into the grid is decreased. The second benefit consists of potential to increase the PV returns in certain countries through significant savings on a consumer's electricity bill. This is achieved by reducing the purchase of high-cost retail electricity during peak demand hours. The third benefit involves the efficient use of energy. Self-consumption empowers the consumers to take responsibility for their energy consumption and production. It helps them to create an awareness on their energy usage and encourages them to take positive, proactive decisions on their daily consumption habits. Another reason why self-consumption is important to consider is because of governmental legislations. Many countries, primarily in Europe, are slowly shifting towards limiting grid injection. These governments are creating legislation that promotes self-consumption. Favorable new policy mechanisms are being adopted that replace old policies, such as feed-in tariffs and green certificates, which will be discussed later in this course. The decreasing cost of PV energy has facilitated policy schemes that aim at being profitable for both the consumers and the government in the long run. So, how can increased self-consumption be achieved? There are two main ways. The first option is to deploy energy storage, such as batteries. In that way, the overproduction can be stored locally instead of being fed into the grid. With a large enough storage capacity integrated into the PV system, the energy availability of the PV system can meet the load demand. This will reduce the interaction of the PV system with the electricity grid. The second option to increase self-consumption is through demand-side management, or DSM. DSM makes use of the concept of load shifting, where the load demands of the household are shifted from time periods with surplus consumption to periods with surplus PV production. By adapting the load demand to the PV production pattern, self-consumption is increased further. So, To conclude, in this video we looked into the concept of self-consumption in grid-connected PV systems. Self-consumption mechanisms will reduce the amount of electricity instantaneously injected into the grid. If a PV system is properly designed, self-consumption can ease the planning and operation of the distribution grids. Moreover, we discussed that the penetration of self-consumption can be increased via two mechanisms, which are the energy storage and demand-side management.